Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTV UK. Welcome back to the channel where today I'm gonna teach you fine folk out there how to do one of the hardest, most intense things you can do with an electric guitar, and that is change the strings on your Floyd Rose system. It's not actually that hard at all. I don't know why there's so much chat online about how difficult it is to change the strings on a Floyd Rose or double locking tremolo equipped guitar, either floating or not floating. Granted, it's not as easy as changing the strings on your Les Paul or your Telecaster. It's a bit more fiddly, it takes a bit longer. It's not necessarily hard. You don't need a magic wand and you haven't got to go to Floyd Rose College to learn how to do it. You've just got to know what to do. And that's what I'm here for today. I'm using the term Floyd Rose as an umbrella term as well, because that's what it's kind of used as. It's just any kind of double locking tremolo system. So it's an Ibanez Edge, a licensed Floyd Rose system, an EVH branded Floyd Rose system, or any of the levels of original special FR1000 Floyd Roses. They're all the same. If it looks a bit like this and does what it does, that's what I'm going to be calling a Floyd Rose today. Personally, I'm a hardcore Floyd Rose user. I love these ridiculous things that help you get mad sounds out of the guitar. 90% of the time at home or live, I'm using a Floyd Rose equipped guitar because a lot of my idols growing up use them too. And it's a lot of fun to set up. Personally, I enjoy setting these up because it's a bit more intricate, it's a bit more fun to tinker on with, and I believe that when you do all the setups and stuff yourself, you establish a cool bond with your guitar and you know how everything works and where everything sits. However, with that, if that's not your jam, don't worry, there's no shame in taking it to your local guitar tech, and if you don't get it right the first time when you try and restring your own Floyd Rose guitar, don't think that in the future you can't do it again. Just keep practicing and eventually you'll get there. Also, check out the description box down below for the timestamps. So if you want to skip to a certain part where you might know how to do half of it, but you don't know how to set up the string tension versus spring tension thing, click that in the description box down below and that'll take you to that little part in the future, which we're not yet at right now when I'm filming this. So that's enough rambling. What am I using here today? The guitar I'm going to be changing the strings on is this lovely PRS S2 Vela, the Vernon Reed signature, the dude from Living Colour, and it's absolutely crackers. I've got a cool little Daddario neck holder here. Speaking of strings, I'm using Daddario strings, XL 9-2-42. So you haven't got to use any special fancy strings or anything. These are just run-of-the-mill awesome Daddario strings. I've got the Allen key, which will come with your Floyd Rose guitar. This is the main Allen key for the locking nut and the string clamps down the back. There is a smaller one as well for the intonation screws, but I'll talk about that more at the end. I have a AA battery wrapped in gaffer tape to make it a bit softer, and this goes under here, as you'll see shortly, to help loosen everything off. And I've got a Daddario pedal chromatic tuner and a Dunlop mat, and that's everything. Let's get started. If you're happy with the way your Floyd Rose equipped guitar is set up and you're simply just changing the strings to the same gauge, it can be a different brand but the same gauge of strings, you haven't got to worry about setting it up afterwards. It should sit perfectly back the way it was, back the way you liked it. But if you change the string gauge, the tension's going to be different, and the Floyd Rose, especially if it's floating, like this Vela is, might dip into the body or might raise up, and it might not be level, messing with your action of your strings. And I'll be talking about that more at the end on how to set that up. I think I'm going down a gauge on this Vela. I think it's got 10s on right now, and I'm putting 9s on, so it'll be fun to mess with that at the end. Right, first things first, we've got to get these strings off. Take that battery or anything, I use a rubber, like a school pencil rubber eraser in the house. Drop the Floyd Rose then plonk it under the Floyd Rose, and that lifts it up a little bit, taking some of the tension off the strings. It's now time to unlock the locking nut at the top, loosening the strings off. I've got one of these funky little Daddario string winder clip things as well. They're awfully handy. Loosen the strings off. You haven't got to get them totally loose because they're going in the bin anyways, so just enough so it doesn't fly up and shoot yourself in the eye, or it fires itself through your cat or something. Take them down. Clip them out, and because you've got that little block under the Floyd Rose, in this case a AA battery, but use whatever kind of block you want, as long as it's not going to chip the paint or bend any of the Floyd Rose, nothing's going to move. So it's the same way it was when I put it down there. It hasn't sunk and it hasn't raised up. Locking tuners are really handy because you just have to lock the screw and you haven't got to worry about winding around and stuff. You lock the string in, but I always find them a bit pointless on a guitar with a Floyd Rose system because it gets locked at the nut anyways. So they're great for tuning. It helps to change the strings, I guess. It makes it slightly easier. However, this isn't very easy. So if you have a locking Floyd Rose system, don't worry too much about upgrading your guitar with locking tuners. With the locking nuts as well, they always go vertical. You can put them the other way, like sideways, but 99% of the time, they go vertical. So the lines, the raised up bits, are aligned with the neck. So that's half the strings gone. The other half is still clamped into the string blocks down here on the bridge itself. And you take your Allen key, the same one for the locking nut, down the bottom here, and just slacken off all of the individual saddles, loosening the little string block clamp, which is clamping the string in place, the little string block, I should say, letting you have your lovely half string. Now that's done, don't tilt your guitar up, don't pick it up, don't do anything, because there's nothing holding those little string blocks in place now you've taken that screw out the back. So they will just fly out and go on the floor. They're not very expensive, but it's a right pain in the ass when you try and find them, or you have to buy some new ones when all you want to do is restring your guitar. I always just slacken them off a little bit more to give me a bit more wiggle room when it comes to putting the new string in. Now that the strings are off, it's a great time to get rid of all that manky finger gunk that gets stuck on the fingerboard and in between the pickups and between the bridge pickup and the bridge system. I love a Relic guitar. Relic guitars are awesome, but when you see gross stuff, like, it's just gross and you want to clean the gross off. Relicing's fine, but nobody likes finger gunk or anything. But this is a new guitar. There's no gunk. It's gunkless. So let's open these lovely Daddario strings. Jewel lock and hydrate. That's what you should use to hydrate your fingerboard. Now, for those in the know, you will know the Daddario strings have a color-coded system. The gold and the red are the two thickest strings. The low E is gold and the A is red. Moving down to the green and the black is the third wound string, so the D and the G is green. And the two higher strings, the purple is the B, and the high E, the thinnest string, is silver. It's all displayed on the back of this little lovely packet right there. Now, there's a few different ways to do this next bit. Some people like doing one whole string at a time. Some people like doing half and half, or even working from E, E, A, B, then the two middle strings, what are the G and D. I like putting all the strings, clamping all the strings in the bridge, and then doing everything up here at the end. So that's what I'm going to teach you guys. If people want to complain, complain, but I've been doing that for years and it always works absolutely mint for me. So now the first bit of Floyd Rose restringer, where it's like, what are you doing? That's ridiculous. You have to cut the ball end off. You know, the ball end, which usually sits in a Stratocaster bridge or in a Les Paul bridge or through a Telecaster. Cut that off, because there's nowhere here. That's not wanted here. You don't need that. What you do with that snipped off bit, the now lovely bare ballless string, is clamp it back where the low E string was. So, because we slackened it off a bit more before, feed it in as hard as you can. So it hits the bottom. Don't let the string block kind of V up against the front, because you might not get the whole clamping the string in. So make sure everything's loose and put it right down as low as it'll go. Then tighten it up. You don't want to tighten it in too much right now. We'll do that later on. And then you do it with all the strings. Simple as that. Clip off the ball end. I feel like I'm in a cooking show right now. I always feel like that when I do these videos. If you want to know some more cool tuning hacks, there's a video without Floyd Roses where I talk about 9 of the most awesome tuning hacks you can do to your electric guitar, acoustic guitar, or bass. That's a cool video. I'll link that in the description box down below. It feels weird not doing this at home and having a camera turned on. Also, not having my cats. If you're if you have cats and you're a guitar player, you know that this is their favorite part of the day. As soon as I open a pack of Daddario strings, the cats are there waiting, because they're like, okay, it's game time. Let's play with some strings. Let's cut our little faces to bits. Yeah. I wish they were here. I'll bring them for the next restring video. So there we go. All the strings are now clamped in the saddles themselves, but they're only kind of finger tight. Now I'm just going to go through and tighten them all. Don't over tighten them. Just tighten them so you can feel a bit of resistance and you can feel that string getting clamped in. If you over tighten them and you go whole hog, you might split the saddle, you might thread the screws, and that means an entire new saddle. Not an entire new Floyd Rose, just a new saddle. So just don't over tighten it. I've over tightened many in my time. So don't be like, I hate myself, I've over tightened this screw. It's just irritating when you do it, because you have to buy a new saddle. So just till you feel it nip, and just tighten it in just like that. Cool, so all tight, good to go. Let's thread the strings up into the tuning pegs. Again, these are locking tuners, so it's a bit easier for me, but just restring your guitar as if you would restring any guitar. Leave a little bit of slack, because that Floyd Rose is tilted up still. When we take that battery out, it will go back in itself, and if you've got lots of tension on, the string might snap, and you don't want that. I've just noticed as well, there's no tension bar on the headstock of this Vela. On your Floyd Roses, you might have a a tension bar like that. Just keeps the strings in place. A little intermission before we tune this up, just to talk about if you haven't got a floating Floyd Rose system. So if you've got a system which just goes down and doesn't pull up, it's pretty much exactly the same. You haven't got to put a battery underneath it or anything because nothing's going to drop down on itself. Just slacken everything off down the bottom. Don't turn it upside down because all the little blocks will fall out, and restring it as you would and then clamp it back in at the bottom. Tune it up, then you're good to go. You kind of just have to stretch it. That's all you need to know about that. So now the strings are wrapped around the tuning keys. I'm going to plonk the little locking nuts themselves, or the locking clamp bit, into the locking nut. Now the strings are super slack, so if I take that battery out now, the whole thing is going to dip back into the body. So I'm going to tighten the strings up a wee bit. Not crazy amounts, just enough to give it a bit of alternate force. Pull, give it some pull so it doesn't dip directly into the body of the PRS. Now for a little service announcement. Never cut these off until right at the end. Literally right at the end, or even just before you're about to go on stage. Don't leave them on, because there's a special circle in hell for people who leave these on the guitar. Even Phil X and Tom Morello. If you snap a string, well, you're not going to snap a string. When you restring a regular guitar and stretch the strings in, the chances are it's going to snap at that little ball end. So the ball end's going to snap off. These aren't a thing on a Floyd Rose, so the worst that can happen is it shoots out of the block itself and out of the saddle, which sucks. However, if you've still got all the winds right here, just snip that little bent bit off and start anew. Thread it back through and then start anew. So don't clip these off till right at the end, just in case something shoots out the saddle, because if you do, there's not enough string to put it back in the saddle. You need to buy some new strings. So that's a little service announcement for you. Now, let's take the battery out and see how far this little Floyd Rose dips. It's dipped a bit into the body. I mean, it's not up to pitch now. When you tune up to pitch, it'll drastically change, but not the worst thing in the world. It's worth now as well just giving it another little check to make sure everything is tight, so nothing's gonna twang out and hit you in the face or hit someone else in the face. So we are good to go. It's very highly strung. The tension is quite high. So let's tune it up to standard and see what the crack is with the old pitch. F sharp, nice. That's a high tuning. Anything you do to change the tension of these strings will alter the pitch of the Floyd Rose. So if you have, say, the top five strings perfectly in tune, as soon as you go to alter that sixth string and it's really flat, if you tighten it up, that's going to tighten the whole bridge, and the whole bridge is going to move up, flattening the rest of the strings. So this is one of the hardest parts about a Floyd Rose system, and that's fine tuning it. So like I said at the start, that spring tension at the back is the same as the string tension on the top. Cool, so that's in tune, standard tuning right there. However, the bridge is properly back in the body. I can't get a camera close enough, so check this out. This is an action cam right here. So you don't want it too far into the body like it is right now. You want it flush. So the Floyd Rose bass plate is sitting flush with the body. You don't want it too far down. You don't want it too far back. You want like Goldilocks' porridge, just perfect in the middle. And that's what we're gonna sort right now. And to do such a thing, you need to slacken the springs off on the back to take some tension away, to slacken them off to bring that Floyd Rose back level. However, again, when you do, the whole guitar is going to be flat. But worry about that in a second. So now the back plate's off with those four little screws. You can see the springs in the back of this Valor. They usually have three, but there's four in this. It must be Vernon Reed's preference. Also, sorry for all the racket up there. It's definitely worth having those strings, though, like I said before. Personally, I always leave the cover off because I think it looks a bit sleeker, but some people don't like seeing the springs. So comment down below if you're a cover on or a cover off kind of person. Let's take the bar off now, because we're going to be leaning it down. You will usually need a thicker Phillips crosshead screwdriver for the screws at the back to alter the spring tension, as opposed to the ones you probably use to take the back plate off, because you might just thread the screw if you use a little one. You need a big guy to grab onto that big X. So just a few turns, nothing too crazy, and always try to make it level. So there's two screws in the back, you don't want it like wonky. Try and make it level, so do the same to both sides. It's not the end of the world if you don't. It might change something. I just don't know. That's what I'm trying to bluff over. So I've slackened it off. Let's tune it back up again and see where we're at. So that's went down a whole tone. It's went from E standard to D. And as you tune it up, you'll be pulling that Floyd Rose back level, where we want it. And no sooner than we've got to the higher E, the low string is now back down to a D, because everything you do affects that tension. I'll tell you what, ladies and gents, you must be good luck watching this video. It's level. That's the first time I've ever adjusted the springs in the back of a guitar, just a random amount, thinking, yeah, this is gonna be about right, and then just tuning it to E standard and it's level. The Floyd Rose is perfectly flush with the body. It's not gonna, you might do it in one go, and then kudos to you, but I don't think I've ever done it in one go, but now I just have, which is probably good for this video, because it's not 10 minutes of me going, right, can we get it perfect, can we get it perfect? That was very lucky. Thank you for all the luck. So now we're in tune. Great guitar, this. I'll put the link for me demoing this guitar in the description box down below. It's got a beautiful V profile neck, which you don't think you'll like until you play it for an extended period of time, and you're like, this is surprisingly comfy. Now it's time to stretch the strings in, which is one of the scariest parts to do, but it's totally fine. If anything comes out, we've got all this slack right there. So set your tuner up, tune it to the pitch you want. Gently grab the string. You can't buy weird doohickeys that do it for you, but grab the string at the bridge and then gently pull it up. It doesn't matter that the Floyd comes up a little bit because you're still stretching some of the tension out the string. And once you've done this, it'll help the string stay in tune for a bit longer because it'll already be stretched in. A lot of folk put new strings on, tune it up, then play it for a bit and go, why is my guitar out of tune? Because the strings haven't been stretched in. Over time, they will settle in, but this is just a way of speeding it up. So I've stretched it there and it's down to D. Back to E. So a couple of stretches down the neck, nothing too crazy. Don't absolutely horse it. Back up to pitch and repeat until the note doesn't really venture from that original note. The G string is the most intense to stretch, whether it be on a Floyd Rose guitar or a regular guitar, just because it's the thickest unwound string and it has the most tension on it. So be wary, but don't be scared. Don't be scared. Down to F sharp, back up to G. I spoke too soon. It's all stretched in now and the bridge is slightly raised up because I was messing on with the tension of the strings. So I'm going to quickly tighten the strings a little bit more into the body. Just a little bit, because as soon as you tighten the strings slightly, they'll go sharp. And you need to flatten them again, hopefully leveling the whole thing out. I was so chuffed as well. Cool, so there we are, nice and flat, finally. Now's the time, if you want to alter the action, give it a little bit of a play because everything will be stretched in. Granted, it's not locked in yet, so if you do hammer the Floyd Rose, it probably won't stay in tune as well as till it's locked in. Set the action up, which is exactly the same. Use the little Allen key, the same one for the nuts at the top and the string clamps at the bottom, and simply place it in the little posts and turn it around, adjusting the height of either side of the Floyd Rose. Also, you can intonate your guitar now. A bit more of a faff on. The little intonation screws down here, there's three little slots that little intonation screw can slot into, and this whole saddle itself moves backwards and forwards. This is a bit harder to do than restring, so if you're not feeling comfortable with that, take it to your local guitar tech and get him to intonate it for you. If not, tune an open string to pitch with the open string itself and a harmonic on the 12th fret. Make sure it's all in tune. Then play the 12th fret of the string you're wanting to intonate. The 12th fret is the octave, so the open E, the E on the 12th fret in this case, it's perfectly halfway between the nut and the bridge of the guitar. And if that 12th fret octave is sharp, you need to move the saddle back, and if it's flat, you need to move the saddle more towards the neck, making the string longer and shorter, helping the guitar, intonating the guitar, helping it to stay in tune with itself. With that, a little goes a long way. Exactly the same with the springs on the back. Just do a little bit at a time, a little goes a long way, and it makes a huge difference. Same with intonating, and the same with raising the action with the two little posts here. Always do either half a turn or quarter of a turn at a time. So if you go too far, you know how much to go back, and write it down if you want to be really, really intense about it. But now, everything's intonated, everything's in tune, everything's stretched in. Now it's time to lock it up and do the final little tuning. When it comes to tuning it and locking it up, always make sure the fine tuners, the little twisty bits on the Floyd Rose itself, are halfway. So they're not too tight in, they're not too loose out. You've got a perfect equal amount of sharpening and flattening the note once it's locked in. One final tune up just to check. All good to go. Now let's lock the locking nut in place. Again, same chat as the saddles. Don't tighten it too much because you might thread it and might have to buy a new nut. Just enough so it all nips in place. So there we go, we're locked in, and that will, in essence, affect the strings. hence the fine tuners. So that's made the E string sharp. Let's slacken it off and do the rest for the rest. You know, Eddie Van Halen invented the fine tuner. The Floyd Rose system, invented by Floyd Rose, was just the clamps themselves. It wasn't until Eddie was like, let's lock it up top. But how do you tune it if you lock it up top and the whole thing slips out of tune because you've clamped the string? Violins have the little fine tuners on. So Eddie was like, let's put fine tuners on the back of a Floyd Rose. And that's where that came from. And with that fun little fact, everything is level, everything's stretched in. We are good to go. We can now clip off the most irritating things in the world. Sorry if you guys love these daft excess strings. I know Phil X spells words out with them. I mentioned Tom Morello loves them before, but I can't get away with them. Let's finally put the bar back in. I'll put the back plate on in a second. And we are good to go. Quite fun playing guitar vertically upright. So that, ladies and gents, is it. How to restring your Floyd Rose equipped guitar, a floating one. Like, only do half of that for the non-floating trems. And again, that's either a Floyd Rose, an Ibanez Edge locking trem, a cheap Chinese copy, a really expensive one from the 80s, all the licensed stuff. It all works the same. But with some of the cheaper stuff, be really careful when it comes to tightening the screws at the back and the locking nuts, because the metal itself isn't as fancy or good as the proper Floyd Rose stuff, and you might thread it a bit easier, making you buy another one. If you want to add anything, please comment down below. If you want to expand on anything that I've said, or if you want to kick off with the fact that I did all the strings at once instead of doing one at a time, just let me know down below in the comments. I like expanding my knowledge on this just as much as you guys, and it's always fun to share information about these daft things that we love and call guitar. And if you like this video, subscribe to PMTV UK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. Like I mentioned, that tuning hacks video and the overall demo of this guitar. It does like to spin though. If you want any more information on, well, this PRS S2 Vernon Reed Vela, get yourself to pmtonline.co.uk, where you can find obviously product information, but also lots of cool blogs about other cool guitar hacks. And if you want to try one out for yourself or get some more information on how to do this in person, call into one of our local PMT stores. There's got to be one near you now. There's like 17 up and down the UK. They'll be happy to help you. Restring, they might hum and haw because it takes a bit of time, but it's not a hard thing to do. It's just a bit fiddly. But you can do it yourself. But if you want a hand, call into your local PMT store and get helped out. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.